Hey guys, welcome back to No Man's Sky. A lot of different things have changed. I was going for the Atlas. As you know, this should correct us to the Atlas, I believe, now. Yes? Basically, the Atlas is like, hey look, you're going the wrong way, you gotta go all the way over here. Because I got, I think, 5 stops away from it, basically, and the game bugged out. And basically, whenever I warped to one station, it told me to go a different way. So whenever I warped back, it told me to go back that way. So I was stuck going between two systems for ages. And it's sad, but it took me three jumps, I think. Possibly 4 jumps before I even fucking noticed, for a start. I was like, I'm just going between the same 2 fucking jumps. And then I wasted another 4 trying to fix it. I turned the game off, turned the game back on, all this shit. And it didn't fucking work. I even tried to use the free exploration thing to try and jolt it back into position by, like, continuing the path. Like, took a picture of it and then, like, tried to continue the pathway in the free expansion thing and then went that way, but it still wouldn't really accept me doing that. And so the Atlas interface has kind of become, like, an inaccessible thing for me to get to. So that night, I did rage a little bit on Twitter, but after that, I kind of was like, you know what, fuck this game, I don't give a shit. Next day, I was like, I fucking want to play No Man's Sky. I kind of want to explore. So I decided to head for the center of the galaxy. Now, we are quite a distance away. I've not got anything to write with. Fuck, I've not even got my book. It's over there. Okay, so we're 17,587. That's actually a lot. That is a lot, isn't it? Hoobles. So yeah, okay. So if you guys remember that, try and remember that, because we're heading for the center of the universe now, or I'm heading for the center of the universe. There's a black hole. I've discovered a black hole. I've been told it's here. Now, I've never seen a black hole before. Apparently it's already been discovered by somebody. That's exciting, right? It's the first thing that we've already that someone else has discovered. I've never been through a black hole before, so I'm gonna go and try and get through the black hole. I'm gonna pray to the whatever I can pray to that it does not crash. Last night it crashed 3 times. I was about to record this and it crashed 3 times, basically. So I can't even remember what I've got. I can't remember what I'm doing. It's just, I was just like, you know what, I don't give a shit anymore. I just need to, I'm giving up tonight because it's crashed like 2-3 times. Now, so I'm back. Hopefully it won't crash on the way to this black hole. Hopefully this black hole will be decent. Apparently black holes are shortcuts to the center of the universe. So he says that. It has been discovered by someone else though, so that's kind of interesting. Oh, okay. Whoa. That's the black hole, huh? Should we go to the space station first? Maybe. Jeez. That's fucking cool. Why are these getting bigger, not small? Why are these not all getting sucked into the hole? That's interesting. It's probably gold. But now I think about it, yeah, my inventory is probably full. You know what, fuck the space station. We probably could get an inventory point for it, but we're going straight for this black hole. So I'm assuming we just have to enter it? Is that right? Although I do feel a little bit anxious about this. It's a bit weird. Oh dear. Oh. Okay, does anyone remember how far away we were? It was 17-something, wasn't it? So we'll look after this, see how far it's taken us. Jesus. So yeah, it took a long way. Basically, I wanted this video as kind of like an end. Like, I wanted to find something interesting This black hole sounded interesting. It looks interesting. I'm assuming it's just like warping somewhere. I wanted to give a few of my final thoughts on the game, really, before I ended everything. Does that make sense? Like, cause I've kind of gone backwards and forwards, backwards and forwards, backwards and forwards through the show so far. Oh, here we are. Undiscovered, huh? Can we go back? Oh, there is nothing. Wow, we traveled quite a bit, and our beam thing has been damaged. Has it? So our beam thing's been damaged. Path towards the Galactic Core. And we've traveled. It says 66, right? Did it say 66 hours? It mustn't have. It must have said something else because we've not traveled that far. Oh well. But this is undiscovered, apparently. Or discovered by me. So does that mean the black holes puke you out at different points? I mean, I guess that must mean exactly what that means. That we get puked out at different points. Because otherwise, the same guy who discovered that black hole would discover... would have discovered this, right? Surely. There was an update to this game, time of recording, this morning. And it seems to be a bit more stable. It didn't really, like, flash or anything like that during that cutscene, which is good. Which is good. It's very, very good. I'm very happy that they got that out pretty quickly, because it was desperately in need of that. But, yeah, so, thank fuck for that. I didn't realise I had so much to sell. Yeah, my final thoughts on the game. As of now, to be honest with you, I don't think it's finished. I don't think it's finished. I don't think this game should have been sold as a released game. I don't think it should have been... I feel like it should have been early access, maybe. Maybe that would have... I think maybe that would have let people... kind of just, like, be a bit more lenient on it. Because I think I was talking to Jade Lightseeker about this, that it's... He was saying that, like, you know, the price is also one of the factors that people are so, the backlash of it. And that, I would agree. I would agree with his comment that it was, that the things that it was, like, multiplayer is not a thing and all this, and that definitely has all factored into the fact of, you know, what this is now. And it is very good at what it does, right? It's very good at exploring and very good at collecting. But other than that, there's kind of nothing else to it. And maybe they don't want nothing else to it. Maybe they didn't want nothing else to it. Maybe this is what his vision was. But every single time we saw this guy at like E3, I can't remember his name. His name escapes me. I'm very, very sorry. Oh, god damn it. I had his name in my head for ages. Like the entire way until I just pressed the record button, and now my brain's just like, what was his name? I'm so sorry, I can't remember the developer's name, but he kind of reminds me of a Peter Molyneux, you know? He like kind of, whether it was intentional or not, I think he did overhype his game, and I think that got a lot of people way too excited about it, a lot more excited than what they should have been. And I do think the game is unfinished. I think it will become better, and I don't think we will come back to this game on the channel possibly until it's finished. If they add like base building, you know, you can build your own spaceships, paint your spaceship, you know, just build stuff, I would be more inclined to play it with some sort of goal in mind. I'd be very much willing to play more of it, because what I've played I have enjoyed. There's been a load of bugs and stuff like that. I'm hoping that patch this morning fixed a whole lot of it. That would have been very much beneficial. This is a cool ship. And this is something that bothers me, right? This is just something that bothers me. There's not enough I can't seem to suspend my disbelief. I think that's kind of the problem. And I think if you're willing to suspend your disbelief, and you can do that, you are capable of doing that, you'll enjoy this game a lot more. But look, we have this space station, right? We have this space station, and we have all these people landing here. But then they don't do anything. There you go, off they go. I don't know why they even bothered showing up. Did they just show up at a place to eat their sandwich? Like, they didn't go up here, they didn't go up, you know, they didn't do anything. They didn't leave the ship. You don't see them walking around. Every single alien you see is in a permanent position. Did we actually talk to this dude? I don't think we did. Let's use him as an example. Like, I can assume that this guy works here, right? He works in this space station, because there's no other spaceships out there that isn't unpiloted. This dude just sits here, and that's all he does. He's clipping through that chair a little bit, but that's alright. Every game does a little bit of clippy. So let's talk to this dude, right? Speaks a language we obviously don't understand. We've got to find the language. That's perfectly fine. So, current life form, a signal. So, okay, from a distant location, deep in space. Rare elements are being pulled from the resources vaults at its feet. But some are running low. Feel bright lights concerning. Upon me. So if I put some of this stuff in, maybe he'll give us something. I don't think he wants us to take shit. That would be odd. So I think I actually have some stuff. But he doesn't do anything, right? Holy fucking shit, look at the size of this thing. This thing's fucking huge. Yeah, come on, I wanna click on this dude. This is another thing that needs to change. Holy shit, this thing is massive. Hey dude, how big is your storage? 35 slots, fucking hell. 11 million. I think I'll ever be able to afford that. It just got back to 1 million. Oh, it's fucking awesome, isn't it? It's awesome and huge. Shit, see you later, friend. Yeah, like, I can't suspend my disbelief because they don't do anything, right? Oh, fuck me. Ships in this zone are massive. Meanwhile, we've just got our little rubbishy one. So, we can head down to a planet, I guess. That one looks like a frozen planet. I'm tired of that. Oh, fucking hell, that one looks nice. Let's go to Homistushi. Homsitushi. Let's head there. See, it's like, I can't really suspend my disbelief on the aliens, and there are a few things that would help me. Like, if aliens moved around a bit more, if they had a little bit more interaction with you, rather than what they just have. Item storage is fine, actually. I'm actually quite a fan of this infantry idea. Like, where you can either have infantry space, or you can have upgrade space. I'm actually a massive fan of this. I like this a lot. It makes you think. I wish I could find a freaking new multi-tool tool though, that's for damn sure. There's a lot of different things. It's like, so we've seen a robot in this system, so this entire system will only be robots. That makes no sense to me, because wouldn't the Gek be trading with them? Wouldn't the, whatever the other one's called, the Viking, the Valkyrie, wouldn't they be trading with them and stuff like that? You know, holy shit, this fucking planet's like fucking beautiful. I've pretty much found like no nice planets. I found one nice planet and like tweeted about it. I was like, holy shit, I finally found a good fucking gorgeous planet, because everything seems to be like a barren wasteland, which is annoying. It's annoying and boring to play through because of that. You know, so let's see if we can find something here to... Here we go, look. This looks like something we can do. Land here, right in the middle of them. Beautiful. There's a big green thing over there as well. The planet that I landed on that was really nice had grass. And I was fucking ecstatic that I had, like, grass. Like, look, oh, grass. That's exciting. Because it's not just fucking plain and boring, and I think this game needs a lot more to it. It needs so much more to it, and I think that is coming. I do think that they're going to be adding to it, because they've already said they're going to add, like, a spaceship thing, I believe. Which was, you know, don't quote me, obviously, but I do believe I heard that building a space station was coming, or a spaceship. Like, I would love to have a massive spaceship and explore like that and have, like, a massive... have something to build on, but I want to build it, you know? I want to build it piece by piece, making it better by better and bigger and bigger. I don't want to have to... I don't want to have to, like, fucking just say, oh, look, here's your spaceship, off you go. Because I don't want that. I don't want to just be like, here's a spaceship, and now that's it. Because that's not exciting. That's boring. That's the same thing, that's the same problem as what we're having now. It's just exploration. And I'm gonna spoil the Atlas run, right? Well, I'm not going to spoil the Atlas run because I've not finished the Atlas run. But after this kind of bugged, I googled what the Atlas thing is. So I'm going to spoil it right now. So if you don't want to know, you know, skip ahead a little bit or turn off completely. Hang on, let's do this first. One, nope. Two, and there's a six in there as well. So it's this one. Here we go, success. That location in the cosmos, which will be on this planet. So it's not in the cosmos at all. It will definitely be on this planet because it always is. Because these are the exact same things. It's like it's procedurally generated, and I understand that, but there's not enough variety for it to procedurally generate with. You know, again with the dinosaurs, it's something that you can suspend your disbelief with, but the dinosaurs, I can't suspend my disbelief with these dinosaurs. How the fuck do I get out of this building? It's like you see the little dinosaurs, you see the little creatures, and they're like, they're not even really like. They're all the same parts, and you see the same parts over and over and over and over again. I think it needs a much bigger pool to like pull stuff from to procedurally generate with, because what's here is good, what's here is very good, but there needs to be more. It's a lack of stuff. The price for the lack of stuff is upsetting, and I think it's upsetting for a lot of people, and that's understandable. I can definitely agree with that. I do believe this game's gonna get better, so we're gonna keep hold of it. I mean, I keep hold of a lot of games, so it's not really that big of a deal, but I mean, I'm definitely gonna keep hold of it for when we hear that there's been significant updates, and then maybe we'll come back and like find other stuff. And it's exciting to see where the game will be able to go. That's definitely a thing. It's very exciting to see where the game will be going. But the launch is definitely hit with lukewarm things, and does it deserve it? I think it does. I think it deserves the reviews that it's getting. Some people who are really aggressive against it, I feel is unnecessary. I feel that's ridiculous because it's perfectly fine as an early access game, is what I'm saying. It shouldn't be priced at what it is, but that's for you not to purchase, basically. Yeah. Don't purchase it if you think it's not worth the purchase. Like, oh there you go, that procedural generated thing did work in eventually. These ruins are another thing. They seem to always be the same type of ruins. Like, I've come across two different types of ruins. These ruins and, like, the bridge ruins. And now, that's fine, but it's always a different, like, language that you're learning, right? You can learn to three different languages. So what are the odds of it always being... What are the odds of the three races? Keep in mind, one of them are a race of cyborgs. Or robots. What are the odds of them all having the exact same structure from children? I'm not even going to read that. Because I don't give a shit. Because it's like... my knowledge has increased. It hasn't. Because there's nowhere to put the knowledge. What I would love is for there to be an encyclopedia. I believe I did say this beforehand, but I would love like an encyclopedia up here of all the words that you can just like learn. Just like all the words that you can learn. I think that would be very interesting, very like fun to do. Because then you could kind of like learn to speak it yourself. I mean, I doubt anyone would actually do that. Oh, look, gold. This is why I want another multi-tool, because this shit takes ages to fucking mine with this one. So I want another multi-tool with a lot more slots. But I've not been able to find one yet. So maybe we'll find one before I'm finished bitching. Where has our ship gone? Our ship is over here. Here we are. The Double Dildo 3000. Why can't we name our ships? That's the thing. I can't seem to find where to name them. If I can name them, let me know, and I'm stupid. Maybe I am an idiot, but how do I name this? How do I name it? Because I can't. I don't want it to be called that. I want to name it something that I want to name it, you know? This can be very buggy. This can be very buggy. The ship flying can be very buggy, which I'm also not a fan of. And the fact that you can go like fast, you can add your boosters on to make it like, you know, get the wind going past you, but your speed won't change. Like, there's a speed down the bottom left hand corner of your cockpit, and it just won't change. Like, so, like, look, this dude here, right? We saw this dude land, which is fucking cool. He's got a cool ass ship, and he's inside this spaceship. Why is he not out? Right? Why would he be landing here just to sit down? That's not what he would be doing. But like, how cool would it be if he was like out and he was like walking in because he needed something, or he needed to buy something from this dude? You know, or if he was walking in to talk to a geck that was in here, that would be so fucking cool. But alas, that's not a thing. Hey buddy, extra life form narrows and masks frustration. Try terminal myself, give a bypass chip. I could make him a bypass chip, but they're illegal. So I'm just gonna try to terminal myself. Pushes away from the terminal. Yeah, I should just give him a bypass chip. Oh, is this actually a fucking thing, is it? But it's not better. It's not better, it's fucking worse. I don't believe it. These are the only ones I find! But they're worse! I don't want it if it's shit. God damn it, I thought I'd like actually found it then. I was like, oh my god, guys, we actually found one. I don't believe it. I only find those shit ones. I don't understand. But I did discover that if you buy a bigger ship, ships that have like bigger infantry space do arrive. And I think that's to try and give you like a sense of progression. It's not enough progression to keep me playing. I've enjoyed my time that I've spent on this game, despite the bugs, despite the mining and all that. I have played it a lot off cam as well. I've explored a lot of planets off camera, generally because it would take too long to explore them all on camera. I think you guys would be very bored of me discovering the exact same things over and over and over again, and not knowing when to stop. You know, on a planet, I see a question mark, I'm like, oh, gotta go get the question mark. Okay, good, it's another one of these. I'm glad it's these ones and not the other ones, because I wouldn't be able to do the other ones. So there is a 3 in the first spot, so it's neither of those, it's this one. There we go. Where is this going to take us? Is this another ruin? Yeah, it looks like it. Well, we can go and inspect that ruin, and maybe I can show you my point of the ruins. Because this will probably be the exact same type of ruins we just saw. It might be in a little bit of a different organization, which is always fun. But never enough for me to give a shit. And here we go. And I would like to... Oh, hello. See you there. I would like to... I'd like to find stuff. You know? I like to find more interesting things. Like, what happened if there was tornadoes? You know? Like, there's a storm incoming and it raises, like, the radiation level of a planet and stuff like that. But what if there was, like, a massive tornado on a planet just ripping it apart? Or if there was, like, a massive earthquake? Or if, like, a planet wasn't stable, you know? Like, there's so many different things that they could do. I mean, what if, like, a star went supernova or something out in space and it, like, wrecked it apart and you had to, like, escape it, you know? Or, I don't know, what if you were in a space station and pirates attacked the space station and you had to, like, fight your way out of the space station to get back to your ship or stuff like that? You know, what, like, actually had to fight actual humans with actual guns? What if that was a thing? And you could use your gun inside? Because you can't use your gun inside buildings. Even inside buildings that are overrun with alien, like, matter. And there's, like, monsters inside. Well, not a monster, because there are no real monsters in this game. There's nothing real. There's, like, there's sentinel dogs. Sentinel, like, little eye fly bots dudes that we've met. Yeah, here we go. There you go, see it? Told you guys. It's the exact same. Is it the exact same? Is the thing in the same place? It is as well. I don't believe it. But it's fine. We get words. But we don't really learn anything about the planet. Because it would be cool to, like, know what happened on this planet and shit, but you don't really ever really find out. There's a little bit of flavor text here, though, which is always nice. Edge of the artifact. Yep, so artifact which your arrival, travelers who would seek the ends of the universe through its very core. Within the infantry of the time, arrival is probable, blah, 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 blah. Yeah. Thanks. I'd appreciate that. And also, it's like you can discover this stuff. But we were quite clearly not the first to discover it, because people are here. I suppose we can name it because we're like, hey look, this is this planet, because I name it, this is the first of our race. I'm assuming we're all humans, and like we are the humans on the planet. Like, I'm assuming that's what it means. But you never see yourself. You know, and that's actually another point. Maybe we can find something that will show you guys what I mean. But it's like, there's no avatar. I would very much like an avatar creation, especially if there's going to be some form of multiplayer in the future. Like, maybe be able to bump into other players in the future. That would be pretty interesting. Whether they'll ever do that, I don't know. The technology might never be there. Not in this game's life form. For it to do that, I guess. Oh, here we go. There's like a little thing here. This will do. Right, so you can see my gun, right? My gun has a grip at the bottom of it. Swap it to the gun. So my gun has a grip at the bottom of it. So I'm shooting my gun. Yep, shoot. And I reload. There's no hand. There's no nothing. My gun just kind of like just floats in the air. Why? Why is that? Why does it do that? Yeah, you can't even get your... Oh, you can get your gun out in these little ones. Oh, no, I can't do anything now. Oh, I think I just got it out while I was walking in. I thought it was immediately wrong then. It was like, you can't get your weapon out inside, and sometimes it can be annoying. Not very often. I assume it's to prevent you from killing the aliens, which it shouldn't. If you want to kill an alien, you should be allowed to kill an alien. You know? If you want to shoot up the Atlas place, you should be allowed to shoot up the Atlas place. Here you go, an incoming storm, right? An incoming storm of, like, fire, of heat for some reason. Why? Why is that on this planet? We don't know. But it would be interesting to find out why. And it would be interesting if they, like, maybe did something with that, like, visually, rather than just telling me that there's a storm. Oh, hello. Oh, a beacon. That's good. Beacons are very cool. Beacons generally give you something interesting. So what is it going to give us? Maybe we can just deal with that. It's going to give us an advanced life form, a shower. That's fine, because there might be an omni-tool there. An omni-tool? It's Mass Effect. A multi-tool. So we'll go there and look and see if there's a multi-tool, and then we'll call it a day. So there's a lot of things that this game frustrates me about, but there is so much here for you to see. Essentially, would I tell you to go out and buy it now? No, I'd wait. Not only would you get the game cheaper, but you would also get the game with like a much higher, like, amount of content. Wait for the game to be fully updated and then buy it, because by then this game will be phenomenal, you know. And we're in an age where games can do that. Games can do a massive turnaround. I mean, look at Final Fantasy 14, that literally re-released, you know, and it's now a great game. I play it all the time. It's fantastic, and it's probably the best MMO I've played, if I'm honest. And, you know, so stuff can do turnarounds these days. They can do it very well, or they can do it, make it even worse. I don't know an instance that I could give you for that. I mean, it's like Tiaria, for example, that Tiaria game. How much has that added since it was released? It's still getting so much new stuff. You know, and like Starbound, that just released from Early Access, and it's like massively, ridiculously extra stuff added to it and stuff. You know, we've got a free antimatter. So this game definitely has, and this game is such a great start. It's such a great start to it. It could have such a massive potential. Oh shit, yeah. What the fuck is that? I don't give a shit, is it good? No, it's not, it's awful. It's 7 slots. What am I gonna do with 7 slots? Look, I have 8. I have 8 slots. Hello. Your Omnitool thing's broken, you know that? What's up, traveler? Yeah, how you doing? Lights went from the mask and beams moving image inside my visor. Complex. The weather's clearing. That's lovely. Understanding it's carefully far beyond my own. Images, chemical, blah, 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 blah. Shows a micro display devices, dance, images for my eyes. Too fast to comprehend. I go ask it to stop, but I realize I could intend ask it to pause, but when? Let's ask it for the chemical formula. That wasn't very exciting, but thank you very much. A sank I don't really use, or ever have to use, because you can just refill it with carbon. But yeah, so overall, guys, I like this game. I really do. I really want it to succeed. The game was massively overhyped. I think we can all agree on that. I think even the people who are ridiculously into this game, I think we can all agree that it's a bit overhyped. Did I go to that space station yet? I think I did. Yeah, I think I did. Let's just head towards the center of the Earth. Center of the galaxy, even. So I was like, yes, the game is massively overhyped. Is it worth the price tag? Probably not at the current time. Is there enough here for it to be warranted a game? Yes, of course. There's plenty of stuff for you to look at and get. But if you're someone like me who needs an end goal, you know, I'm very someone, even like a game like Skyrim, I can explore for hours, but I know there's something that I have to deal with eventually. There's an end goal. My end goal in this is to get to the center of the galaxy, and I don't even know why. I don't know why I'm going to the end of the galaxy. I never did spoil the Atlas, did I? I'll spoil it right at the end. I'll explain right at the end. We can go ahead and hear now. It's just, I wish there was more, and there's going to be more. So until there is more, this is goodbye for No Man's Sky on our channel, basically. And once there is more, like spaceships and stuff like that, stuff, just more stuff, we'll come back to it. Okay, guys? So as for the Atlas stuff, for those who wishes to know, I'm so sorry, my brain is awful. I just completely forgot about it. Basically, from what I read when I Googled it, nothing happens. Nothing happens, and there's like a whole bunch of flavor text, from what I can tell. And then nothing gameplay-wise changes. You can then see black, it gives you the technology to see black holes on the map, on the free exploration map or something, which is very, very cool. Or you can either do that, or you can like, just refuse to not to give it the 10 Atlas keys that you've gathered along the way. And it, like, gives you a super shortcut to the center, like a massive, massive distance. I'm assuming it just kind of, like, fixes the distance that you've walked away so far. And then you can sell all those Atlas stones, I guess, instead of giving it in. Because the Atlas stones are worth a fucking load. Hey, dude, you're just standing there. What are you up to? Yeah, he's... So these are warriors, right? These guys are warrior types. I wish there was more races as well. As far I've only met three. Take multi-tool. Here you go. I don't give a shit. Whatever it said, I'll take it. 10 slots. 10 slots. It's still a bit shitty, but you know what? It's 10 slots and it's fucking free. So... Yes, please, my friend. Holy fuck! I don't believe we finally got a new fucking multi-tool. I don't believe we actually managed to find ourselves a new multi-tool. That's fantastic. So now I can actually put some actual upgrades into it, and we can actually do stuff. I don't need that either. Do I need the antimatter? Yeah, I do. Do we need that? Yeah, I do. Zinc? Always expensive, but I always need it, so... Alright, so, right, let's head back to our ship, because we've done all we can here, and then we move on to the next system. And that's it. That's the game. That's the game for me at the moment. And, yes, it is calming. It's oddly calming, actually. But, oh shit, yeah, those broke going through the thing, didn't it? Yes, it is oddly calming. I will definitely agree to that. But I don't... Yes, it's all the calming. Yes, it's good. I do enjoy this game. I need it to be better. I need it to be more, basically. That's what I'm trying to say. All I need is more. Because it is enjoyable. It's enjoyable. It's great. I just need more. So, that's it. Thank you guys so much for watching No Man's Sky. That is effectively the end of No Man's Sky for now. If you guys did enjoy... Geez, anyone know if these stack? Yeah, fuck it, probably do. If you guys enjoyed this, please let me know. If you didn't enjoy it, please let me know as well. There are two buttons. There is a like and a dislike. You can decide. There is other stuff coming out on my channel. Hopefully, Attack on Titan and Pokemon Snap. Hopefully, he says hopefully. Hopefully, Pokemon Snap has already started. Hopefully, you're watching that by the time this goes out, but I've enjoyed what I've done here. I hope you guys have enjoyed the series as well. It's sad to end it so short, so quickly, I guess, but with the Atlas thing breaking and me just basically getting bored without having, like, something to build, you know, without that, there's not much left for me here. So, other than that, thanks so much, and I'll see you all on our next adventure. Bye-bye.